Blackstone Audio presents Commies, A Journey Through the Old Left, the New Left, and the Leftover Left by Ronald Radosh, read by Yuri Rasovsky. For Alice, with whom I share a wonderful life, and for her love and warmth and support. And for Laura, Daniel, and Michael, so they know where their dad is coming from. 1. Red Diapers. Ron Kovic, the radical Vietnam vet, claims sarcastically to have been born on the 4th of July. I have always thought of myself, with growing irony, as having been born on the 1st of May. In a sense, the first step of my journey to America, a country where I was born but didn't fully discover until middle age, took place on May Day 1939. One of the photographs I have inherited shows me as a baby, 1.5 years old, bundled in a stroller and about to be paraded down Fifth Avenue in the yearly Communist Party celebration that went through the garment center of the then radical needle trade unions, ending with a mass rally at Union Square, for decades the historic center of radical protest. That day, it seems to me, was my baptism into the world of Jewish radicalism, a world so small and insular that it existed inside a political and social ghetto. It is now a lost world, yet one well captured by the late Irving Howe in his classic book, The World of Our Fathers. I almost didn't enter that world at all. Those in charge of preparing for the revolution could not afford the frivolity of having children. And when my mother found in her late 30s that she was pregnant, it was an unexpected and in some sense an alien event. My father had come from a large family and I had many cousins, but among their friends in the movement, my parents were almost the only ones to have a child. Politics notwithstanding, they were devoted and loving parents who continually sought my best interests, which sometimes meant shielding me from the movement's dark side. My father, Reuben Radosh, was a milliner, having learned to design women's hats in turn-of-the-century Poland. Coming to the United States shortly before the outbreak of World War I, he was drafted into the U.S. Navy. After serving his stint, he quickly got a job at a millinery factory, where he became active in the Hatters Union, officially known as the Hat, Cap, and Millinery Workers of America, an American Federation of Labor craft affiliate. In that union, he became an activist in the Radical Caucus and served as a leader in one of the earliest communist fronts, the Trade Union Unity League. The TUUL was an instrument set up by the Communist Party during the so-called Third Period, when the Communist line spoke of imminent revolution and the party sought to move working-class militants out of the regular AFL unions and into a new revolutionary trade union federation. My father quickly became the TUUL's classic frontman, a non-communist who accepted party leadership and who sought to get his fellow workers to split their union and move it under party control. He almost succeeded. The official history of the union, published in the 1960s, notes that in the late 1920s, he ran for president of the union with one opponent, the moderate trade unionist Alex Rose. My father was more radical and also more naive. Ballots were supposed to be listed alphabetically, but before they were printed, Rose asked my father if it would be all right for him to put his name on the ballot first. Certain that he was going to win, my father immediately agreed. He didn't realize that in the community of immigrant workers, many who still could not read English voted for the first name they saw. And so my father's magnanimity led to his electoral loss and to a lifetime of hard work in the city's hat factories instead of a desk job among the union bosses. Rose fared much better. Those who grew up in New York City would later all know his name. A major power...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.